Hello and welcome. Today we will show you how you can send alerts from Zabbix directly to your SIGNL4 team. Here you can see the Zabbix console, in which you can already see a problem and open alarm. This alarm has already been sent to our SIGNL4 team. So when we look into our SIGNL4 app on our phone, we can see an open alarm. When we open the alarm, we can see the details as usual, and we have the option of confirming the alarm. If we confirm the alarm, our team will be notified. The team can then see that I am tending to this alarm. In this case, this information is also reflected in Zabbix. And if we go into Zabbix, we can see that I have confirmed the alarm. We can also see this with other interactions inside the app. For instance, if I add an annotation saying "I'll take care," this can also be seen by my SIGNL4 team. And this is also reflected in the Zabbix console so that this information is accessible in both instances. Of course, it is also possible to close the alarm after the problem is resolved. There are no more open alarms visible, and this is also reflected in the Zabbix console. How is this two-way communication possible? From Zabbix version 5 upward, or more precisely, from version 5.1, a new media type exists. If we scroll down to media type, there is a media type specifically for SIGNL4. Inside this, standard values are predefined, so all you need is your team secret, which is your SIGNL4 team secret, which you can type into this field. This is the only thing in the media type which you have to configure. If you haven't updated to Zabbix 5.1 yet, you have the possibility of looking under Zabbix Solutions and searching for SIGNL4. And downloading the XML file. In addition to this media type, we also need a user. In our case, we'll take the Zabbix administrator to whom you'll send any alerts as usual. So the user can function as a SIGNL4 team, we will use the media type SIGNL4. The rest of the options inside of this media type are fine with the whatever options you choose. The important setting here is that you choose the SIGNL4 type. Here at the Send To field, you can also import your team secret, but it does not have to be input here. This is all that is needed for you to configure your SIGNL4 team to receive alerts from Zabbix. What we've seen, however, is two-way communication. Updates, confirmations, and closed alarms are all communicated back to the Zabbix server. To achieve this, another connector in SIGNL4 is necessary. So if you go into your SIGNL4 portal and look under the apps page, you have a Zabbix connector. All we have to do is enable this Zabbix connector and configure it accordingly. All we need is our Zabbix username and password, along with the access rights to access the Zabbix URL. The URL is the link to reach Zabbix from outside the Zabbix system. It is important to get the network administrator to open the pertaining firewall ports, usually HTTPS port 443, so you can reach this portal from outside and make it possible for SIGNL4 to execute any updates. With these settings set and this app enabled, you now have two-way connectivity from Zabbix to SIGNL4 and back to Zabbix. Thank you, and that is it for today. See you very soon.